Okay, in the following example, we're taking a look at the sine of 22.5 degrees. Now, it's kind of an odd number. Well, by that I mean weird or strange, out of the ordinary when we're taking a look at these, you know, functions or trig ratios of some certain degrees. 22.5, what's up with that, you know? Well, what we're talking about here are half angle identities. So what we're going to do is we're going to call this guy some value a over 2. And what we're doing is our job will be to figure out, well, what exactly was a? If this is a divided by 2, well, if we double it, we'll get our a. So let's think about this. 22.5 degrees times 2. What is that? Well, that's 45 degrees. Okay. So we're going to use this knowledge here, and we're going to apply it to one of these half angle identities. And let's take a look. It's a sine, right? So sine of a over 2, that corresponds to this function or this formula, this identity right here. And so sine of a over 2 equals, and it says plus and minus the square root of 1 minus the cosine of a over 2. Now it all depends, of course, the plus and minus here. Whether or not, you know, the a to begin with was positive, well, not necessarily positive, but what quadrant it lies in. All right, so in this case, 45 degrees, it's in the first quadrant. So we're going to be considering the positive case here as part of our answer. So not really much to worry about. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to rewrite this, and I'm going to say, okay, sine of 22.5 degrees is the same as the sine of 45 over 2. All right, we're going to keep that in mind. And then we're going to set it equal to this square root that was in the formula over here, that was in the identity, 1 minus the cosine, in this case, of 45 degrees. All right, and then we're going to divide all of that by 2. All right, so from here on out, the rest is pretty simple. But we're going to go ahead and continue to simplify this. Now, we're going to need to know what the cosine of 45 degrees is. So we go over here, 45 degrees, and the cosine here is the square root of 2 over 2. So we're going to need that right now when we go back to the problem. So let's see here. This is equal to 1 minus the square root of 2 over 2. All divided by 2. All right, so what we're going to do on the inside is try to clear the fractions, and in order to do that, we see we've got this denominator 2 that we want to clear right in this area. Okay, so we're going to clear that by multiplying the whole fraction on the inside by 2 over 2, and we distribute. All right, so what does that give us? Well, that gives us a giant square root for sure. 2 times 1 is 2. 2 times the square root of 2 over 2 is the square root of 2 itself. And in the denominator here, we have 2 times 2, which is 4. So we have something that looks like this. All right. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to factor out this 1/4 for a second, put it like this, in parentheses, 2 minus the square root of 2. And I know that 1/4 is a perfect square fraction. It is equal to 1/2. If you take the square root of 1/4, it's 1/2. Leaves you inside with 2 minus the square root of 2. And so you have an answer that looks like this for this half angle problem. All right. So the sine of 22.5 degrees is this half of the square root of 2 minus the square root of 2. And I know the answer looks a little bit funny, but it's perfectly all right in trig and when you're working with these identities to get an answer that looks like this. Okay, so we've got this problem down, and let's go ahead and take a look at another example. All right, so I'm going to let's just go ahead and clear all of this right here for a second. So I'll be right back. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at one more, or another example, I should say, because I think we'll take a look at two more at least. We have the cosine of pi over 8, and again, this is a half angle identity as well. So this is our a over 2. So what we're going to need to do is we're going to need to double this pi over 8 here. All right, so we're going to double it, and that'll give us our a value. So pi over 8 times 2 gives you pi over, well, 2 pi over 8, which is pi over 4. All right, so what you're going to do is you're going to use this pi over 4 as your a value. And you're going to say, well, let's take a look at cosine of pi over 4 over 2. And I know it looks kind of funny, like a fraction over another fraction, but this is exactly what we're going to do, because we need to get this value here, this a value, all right? And we need to use it for our function or our identity, which is the cosine of a over 2, which is this guy right here, all right? So let's go ahead and take a look at that, all right? So we're going to come in here. We're going to write it out, and we're going to say, let's erase that real quick. We're going to say, well, this is the square root of the cosine of pi over 4 plus 1 all divided by 2. Now, this works like the previous example, except now we're dealing with radians, but it's not a big deal. So let's go ahead and take a look at the cosine of pi over 4. Cosine of pi over 4 is this guy right here, the square root of 2 over 2. We're in quadrant 1. So we know we're going to be dealing with a positive value for cosine. So let's see here. We have the square root of the square root of 2 over 2 plus 1 all divided by 2. And we're going to clear the fraction by multiplying the top and the bottom by this 2 over 2 here. Now this will help clear this fraction that's right in this area. So we're going to multiply or distribute, okay, that right there. And we are going to get the square root of 2 on the top plus 2 divided by 4. Now, the 2 and this 2 right there cancel each other out. That's why we're left with this. 2 times 1, 2, and 2 times 2, 4. So that's how we get that. And then again, we're going to factor out that 1 fourth. I'm going to have 1 fourth factored out, multiplied by the square root of 2 plus 2, in parentheses, all under that radical. And then 1 fourth is a perfect square, so we get 1 half, and then multiplied by the square root of 2 plus 2. So it looks something like this right here. All right, and this actually ends up being our answer. All right, so go ahead and let that sink in. You might want to pause this right now. I'm going to pause myself, and I'm going to clear the board, and we're going to take a look at one more example. Okay, in this last half-angle example, we're going to take a look at one for tangent. We've looked at a sine, we've looked at a cosine. Now let's take a look at one for tangent. We've got the tangent of pi over 12. So let's go ahead and multiply this by 2. So 2 times pi over 12. This will give me 2 pi over 12, which is pi over 6. So that's my a value there, right there. I'm looking in this case at the tangent of pi over 6 all divided by 2, in other words. All right, so now we've got some choices for tangent. There's 3 different ones right here, and it's your choice what you want to go with. I think I'm going to go with one that doesn't involve square roots. I think those square roots look kind of nasty sometimes. So I'm going to take a look at this one. I think that'd be a good one to take a look at. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at that one right there for a second. So let me go ahead and copy that one down. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to write this as 1, okay, wrong pen color. Let me switch that out. 1 minus the cosine, in this case, a was pi over 6. So pi over 6 all divided by the sine of pi over 6. Okay, so this is really nice because all I got to do is look at cosine and sine of pi over 6 and just kind of plug in those numbers there. So let's go ahead and zoom in on our pi over 6. At our pi over 6, our cosine is this square root of 3 over 2, and our sine is this 1 over 2. So I'm just going to plug that stuff in right in here into my problem real quick. Let's see, here we are. And let's see, I'm going to have 1 minus, instead of cosine pi over 6, I said it was the square root of 3 over 2. And the sine of pi over 6 becoming 1 half. So it looks something like this. And I always tell my students, I say, okay, when you're dividing fractions, always remember to KFC. Now, I'm not trying to advertise for any kind of chicken joint or anything like that. What I am saying is, when you're dividing fractions, always remember to keep the first fraction. So this one right here at the top will be our first fraction, and we're going to write it as such. 1 minus the square root of 3 over 2. And then you're going to flip the second fraction. 1 over 2 becomes 2 over 1, and 2 divided by 1 is just 2. So I'll write 2, and then change the sign from division to multiplication. So then it becomes a really simple distribution problem. 2 times 1, and 2 times the square root of 3 over 2. 2 times 1, of course, is 2, and 2 times the square root of 3 over 2 looks something like this. Of course, you might see that these 2's here cross out, and you are left with something that looks like this, 2 minus the square root of 3. And this right here is actually the answer for this tangent of pi over 12 that we started with. So it's a really nice clean answer and a really nice clean use of this formula. I think the tangents are actually really nice in this case in the half angle identities. Of course, we avoided using the square root function, and that was great. So either one of these tangent identities at the bottom here would work out really nice when you're solving these kinds of problems. So again, this is a look at the half angle identities, if you will, for trigonometry. And I think they're really great. Again, a lot of applications when you get to your calculus course. So good luck with this.